Dear students, welcome to the 8th part of your module 2 of the subject Engineering Statistics and Linear Algebra. In this session, we shall work out some problems on some of two independent random variables, central theorem, central limit theorem and averages. Okay. So, once again, recall the concepts which you have studied under these topics. I'll directly go to the problem. The random variable x is uniformly distributed between plus and minus 1. Two independent realizations of x are added. That means y is taken as x1 plus x2. What is the PDF for y? So here required answer is probability density function PDF for the sum of two random variables. Independent, it is given, independent realizations of x. What is the random variable x here? X is uniformly distributed between plus or minus 1. Okay. Now for my convenience, since we have already worked out problems with the sum of x and y, I am replacing x1 by x here, taking x1 as x and x2 as y and this sum as w. I am taking w equal to x plus y, where x and y are independent realizations of same condition. Independent realizations of uniformly distributed random variable between plus or minus 1. Okay. You can continue with x1 and x2. I am just changing to the sum as w equal to x plus y for my convenience. Now, what is the PDF of a uniform random variable? Once again, recall the topic which you studied in your first module. If uniform random variable is defined in the interval a to b, then 1 by b minus a is the PDF. Recall the formula. Here a is minus 1, b is 1. So 1 divided by b minus a means you get 1 by 1 minus minus 1. It becomes 1 by 2. And in other region, it should be either otherwise, in other regions it is 0. So this is for the first random variable x. Again, it is given that y is also a uniform random variable in the same interval, correct? Both x and y are independent realizations of the uniform random variable between minus 1 and 1. So for y also, you are getting the same PDF, 1 by 2 if your x is in between minus 1 and 1 and 0 otherwise. And you studied the probability density function for the sum of two independent random variables is given by fw of w equal to minus infinity to infinity fx of x into fy of w minus x dx. Correct? This is nothing but convolution of fx and fy. Remember this formula, very important formula. Now, before using this formula, you have to consider the possible values of w. That means here x varies from minus 1 to 1, y also varies from minus 1 to 1. In that case, range of x is this, minus 1 to 1, range of y. In some textbooks, they also use a word support of x is r suffix x equal to minus 1 to 1 and support for y. Range, I am using the word range here. Range of y is minus 1 to 1. In that case, sum will range from minus 2 to 2. How to decide that sum is ranging from minus 2 to 2? You just add the lower limit of your interval. Add the lower limits, minus 1 to minus 1 and minus 1. And add the upper limits. So you get the range for the sum w, which is minus 2 to. Now, if you draw the PDF's curve for uniform distribution from minus 1 to 1, you get this type of curve. Okay, this is for the random variable x. Similar region you get for the random variable y. Because here, both random variables x and y are uniform between the same interval minus 1 to 1. Correct? Only to show you the difference of these two, I have given different colors. This is the random variable x. And this is the random variable y. Okay. And what is the amplitude, height of this? It amplitude is nothing but 1 by b minus a. So here you get half as the amplitude. You can mark it here while drawing the figure in your notes. Mark this height as half, 1 by 2. Here also, this is half. Okay. Now, when you are using the convolution theorem, fx of x is taken as it is, but fy of w minus x, how to obtain this? Start from fy of x, then obtain the reflection of fy of x on your y-axis. Okay, assume that y-axis acts as a mirror. In that case, reflection of your fy of x in the y-axis gives you fy of minus x. Okay, we also call it as flipping. And after obtaining the reflection, you have to move that reflection using this w units. Okay, shift parameter. So I am just showing you the figures of reflection of fy of x. It is again same curve. Why? Because of the symmetry. This uniform distribution from minus 1 to 1, actually it is taken as a symmetrical curve about y-axis, and we also take it as an even function. Even function means when you draw the graph of an even function, always the graph will be symmetrical about y-axis. Okay, so even if you take the image of this full inside the y-axis, again you get the same image, reflection or flipping or reversing. We use different words, flipping the curve, reversing the curve, or finding the reflection of the curve. You get the same region, okay, as it is shown here. Similar region you get here. Now, shift this part by w units. So, take some arbitrary value for w to get the shifted portion of fy of minus x. Okay, this should be suffix y, f suffix y of minus x. Okay, shifted portion of fy of minus x. That gives you fy of w minus x. Now, use that convolution formula for different cases. Okay, which are the cases? First case, when w is less than minus 2. Okay, once again recall, how is your fy of minus x? It is in this form. You are shifting this by w. Okay, when you shift this to the left side, then actually w will be negative. And if you are shifting to the right side, then w will be positive. Correct? I am taking some negative value of w now. If your w value, shifted amount, is less than minus 2. Okay, in that case, I am taking general point as w here. Since your distribution is uniform, there is symmetry. Correct? I am taking midpoint as w, then right side border will be w plus 1, left side border will be w minus 1. And how to decide this w minus 1 and w plus 1? Once if you select the midpoint as w, then the width of this uniform distribution, that will be 2, correct? Here also width is 2. Here also width is 2. To get width as 2, if this is w, this should be w plus 1 and this should be w minus 1. So that there is symmetry about this line w. Okay, generally we take this. So if your w is less than minus 2, if your w is somewhere here, okay, in that case, what will be w plus 1? When w is less than minus 2, w plus 1 will be less than minus 2 plus 1. That means minus 1. Correct? That means this point, this side will be less than minus 1. But your fx of x lies only from minus 1 to 1. Clearly, there is no overlapping region. So, if your w is less than minus 2, fw of w is 0. Now, let us consider the next possible case. Next case is, if your w is greater than minus 2 but less than 0. And how to decide this interval? Okay, write down x and y values at this side, which are the values of x. Interval of x is minus 1 to 1. Interval for y is again minus 1 to 1. Try to add each limit, lower limit and upper limit of x interval with lower limit and upper limit of y interval. So x interval minus 1 and y interval minus 1, when added you get minus 2, this value. From the x interval, if you select 1 and from the y interval if you select minus 1, then you get the answer 0. From the x interval if you select 0 and from the y interval if you select 1, sorry, minus 1 and 1, correct? From x interval if you select minus 1 and from y interval if you select 1, then also you get the answer 0, correct? And from x interval if you select 1 and from y interval if you select 1, you get 2. So which are possible values of sum now? When you split like that, you get minus 2, 1 and 0. Minus 2, 0 and 2, correct? Minus 2, 0 and 2. You better write that explanation separately at this side. So minus 2 to 0, I am taking one interval. Again 0 to 2, I am taking another interval. Minus 2, 0 and 2, you get the sum. So I am minus 2 to 0. When W is in between minus 2 and 0, I am showing that in this figure, W is somewhere here in between minus 2 and 0. Clearly, W plus 1, just see this interval. What will be W plus 1, upper limit of your this region? W is less than 0 means W plus 1 will be less than 1. So your upper limit should be less than 1 anywhere. Okay, it depends on your W value. W plus 1 is less than 1, left side of 1. So sometimes your region you may get till here also. And what about lower limit? Lower limit of the second PDF is W minus 1, correct? W minus 1 will be greater than minus 3. W minus 1 will be greater than minus 3. If W is greater than minus 2, subtract, it will be greater than minus 3. So anywhere you may get. So this end will be more than minus 3 and this end will be less than 1. W plus 1 will be less than 1. So I have given one figure with the sum W plus 1 here. It is less than 1 anyway. You get this region. Okay. Do you get any overlapping region now? Yes. Because your fx first PDF starts from minus 1. Okay. Minus 1 to 1. And this PDF ends here at W plus 1. And what is the common region? This region. You can see the difference in the color. For that region, which are the limits? Limits are from minus 1 to W plus 1. So I have selected here limits from minus 1 to W plus 1 and fx of x value is 1 by 2 and fy of W minus x is same as fy of x. Once if you decide the limits, you can substitute fy of x value 1 by 2 dx. Now integrate. So your main decision about the interval is important. Now integration you can do. Integrate and check the answer, you get 1 by 4 into W plus 2. Next interval, I am taking 0 to 2. Case 3, when W is in between 0 and 2. Okay, when W is in between 0 and 2, in that second figure, okay, this fy of x figure, W plus 1 is the upper limit, correct? Where is your W plus 1? W is less than 2 means W plus 1 will be less than 3. And W minus 1 will be less than 1. So I have taken, just to subtract 1 and check here. W minus 1 will be less than 2 minus 1. So it will be less than 1. So I am taking the lower end here, less than 1 somewhere here. And upper end here, W plus 1. And W is the midpoint. So that the width of the curve is 2 units, once again verify while drawing the figure, be careful, width should be 2 units. So in that case, what is the common region? You get this common region. Okay, see the figure, you get this common region. See the change in the color. So for this common region, which are the limits? Lower limit is at W minus 1 and upper limit is at 1, exactly 1, because after 1, your first curve does not exist. First curve exists only from minus 1 to 1. So for this region, which are the limits? W minus 1 to 1. I have written the limits here. And your fx of x value is 1 by 2. And fy of W minus x value is 1 by 2. So for this region, this satisfies your PDF. 1 by 2. Substitute, integrate. You know the integration. you get the answer 1 by 2 into 2 minus W. And what happens if your W is more than 2? W is more than 2. Okay, I have selected W somewhere here, which is more than 2. This is your point 2, more than 2. When W is more than 2, clearly your lower end point, W minus 1 of this region, second PDF, W minus 1 will be greater than 2 minus 1. That means 1, correct? So your lower end point will be right side of, it is greater than 1 means right side of this 1. This is lower end point, W. Okay, correct here, this is W minus 1. Correct this end point, W minus 1. This is W. This is W minus 1. Okay. And this is W plus 1. Anyway, do you have any common region here? No. So when there is no common region, your PDF is 0. So I think you understood. So we considered 4 cases. First case, when W is less than minus 2, there is no common region. When W is in between minus 2 and 0, in that case, you get the PDF. When W is from 0 to 2, in that case also you get some PDF. If W is greater than 2, there is no PDF. Okay, this is your answer. We have mentioned that we changed from X1, X2 to capital X and capital Y and capital Y to W. Okay, if there is any confusion, again rename. W is nothing but Y and X1 and X2 are nothing but X and Y. So this is the answer. Next question. X is a random variable uniformly distributed between 0 and 3. Y is a random variable independent of X, which is uniformly distributed between plus 2 and minus 2. And W is X plus Y. What is the PDF for W? Once again, similar question. Question is from sum of independent random variables. It is selected from your model question paper. Now, first PDF is uniform PDF, uniformly distributed random variable, but interval is 0 to 3. So in that case, what is your PDF for first random variable? Take it as X. It is 1 divided by B minus A. What is your interval here? A to B, 0 to 3. B minus A means 1 by 3 minus 0. You get 1 by 3. And 0 otherwise. Okay. And this is typing error, write it as otherwise, correct it. Next, Y is a random variable which is uniformly distributed between minus 2 and 2. 2 and minus 2 or minus 2 and 2, meaning is same. So you write minus 2 and 2. What is the PDF? 1 divided by B minus A. B is 2 here, A is minus 2. So 1 divided by 2 minus minus 2, you get 1 by 4. This is the PDF for Y. Okay. Now take the sum of these two. To find the PDF of W, you need convolution integral, correct? PDF of W is given by this convolution integral, minus infinity to infinity fx of x into fy of W minus x dx. What is the range for x here? 0 to 3. And range for y is minus 2 to 2. Hence, range for W will be minus 2 to 5. Just add these lower limits and add the upper limits. You get minus 2 to 5. Now PDFs for fx and fy you can draw easily. Uniform distribution from 1 to 3, 0 to 3, first distribution. Okay, and what is the height amplitude of this? It is 1 by 3. And here uniform distribution from minus 2 to 2, fy of x, and amplitude becomes 1 by 4. Okay, amplitude is 1 by 4. 1 by 3 is slight greater than 1 by 4. So this amplitude is slight greater than this amplitude. Okay. These are the two given PDFs. Now what is your convolution integral? Fx of x is kept as it is. This is fixed. So we fix this PDF and move only this PDF. Fy of W minus x. Okay, first step is find Fy of minus x. That means reverse this figure. Reverse this figure or take the reflection of this on the y-axis. Since this region is symmetrical about y-axis, even if you find the reflection, you get the same region again. okay, fy of minus x will be same. Then shift that fy of minus x by w. Okay, take some arbitrary value for w. So I have separately shown you fy of minus x figure here. It is similar to your fy of x. Now take arbitrary w to get shifted portion of fy of minus, again typing error, this should be suffix fy of minus x, that is to get fy of w minus x. Okay, you can shift it to the left side or right side. If you are shifting this to the left side, you get this portion. If you are shifting to right side, you get some other portion that we will decide later. So this is shifted part of this. Okay, at some stage where after shifting it, you take the midpoint as w, then your one right side endpoint, or you can say right border of this uniform distribution, as is at w plus 2, and left side border is at w minus 2. So that the total width of your fy, pdfy, is nothing but 4 units. Minus 2 to 2, 4 units. Here if you take w as the general point, midpoint, then right side limit is taken as w plus 2, left side limit is taken as w minus 2. And it changes with your w value. It is not fixed. That's why we are writing in terms of w here. Okay. Now first case, how, if your w is less than, what is your range of w? Minus 2 to 5. If your w is less than minus 2, what happens? If your w is less than minus 2, okay, in this figure actually I have selected w less than minus 2. Your minus 2 is here. W is left side. Okay. In that case, w plus 2 comes here and w minus 2 comes here. Correct? W plus 2 will be less than 0 and w minus 2 will be anyway left side limit. In that case, do you get any common region for this fx of x and this fy of w minus x? No, correct? So your first case, if w is less than minus 2, then there is no common overlapping region, hence fw of w equal to 0. You can refer the previous figure. With this, you can also draw fx of x. Okay, I have not drawn fx of x here. And then find out which is your fx of x, this region. So when you draw that region, clearly fx of x is to the right side of y-axis and this lies to the left side of y-axis. Clearly there is no common region, correct? So your first case, when w is less than minus 2, there is no PDF. Second case, minus 2 to 1. How to decide this? Once again, I told you the technique. Write all values of x. X values are 0 to 3, correct? And y values are minus 2 to 2. Add 0, 3 with minus 2 to 2 term by term. 0 with minus 2, you get minus 2. 0 with 2, you get 2. Then 3 with minus 2, you get 1. 3 with 2, you get 5. Okay, so list all the values now. Which of the sums you obtained? Minus 2, 1, then 0, 3 and minus 2, 2, correct? 0 with minus 2 is minus 2. It is better to write at the side. Okay, 0 with minus 2 is minus 2. 0 with 3 is 3. Sorry, 0 with 2 is 2. So you have 0 and minus 2. Then upper limit of first PDF, 3. 3 with minus 2 you get 1. And 3 with 2 you get 5. So total possibilities are 0, 2, 1 and 5. So split the interval accordingly. So 1 is there. So minus 2 to till 1, then 1 to 2, then 2 to 5 and after 5. Okay. So I have, you can divide like that. So minus 2 to 1, if you have the W somewhere here, I have shown you that portion in the figure, some W is somewhere here. In that case, what will be the upper side, right side of this region? W plus 2, W is less than 1 means W plus 2 will be less than 3, correct? So W plus 2 will be clearly less than 3 in the figure. And W is greater than minus 2 means W minus 2, lower end point, W minus 2 will be more than minus 4. Anyway, W minus 2 is somewhere here. You can use trial and error method and decide this region. So W is somewhere here in between minus 2 and 1, I have selected. In between minus 2 and 1, I selected W. In that case, what is the overlapped region for these two PDFs? See the figure. This right side region, yellow colored region, is for first PDF, and this violet color region is for the second PDF. See the intersection. This intersection part is for both PDFs, overlapping region. So which are the limits for this region? This upper end point W plus 2 and lower limit is 0. Correct? So 0 to W plus 2. I have written the limits here, 0 to W plus 2. And what is your fx? 1 by 3. And fy is 1 by 4. Substitute and integrate. After writing the limits, you know the method. Get the answer. Here equal to sign is missing. Include it. Equal to. So this is in the interval minus 2 to 1. Next interval, 1 to 2. 1 to 2. I told you different possible sums are minus 2, 1, 2, correct? 5, etc. So 1, minus 2 to 1 is taken. Now 1 to 2. Next to 2 to 5. In that way we take the interval. So 1 to 2. If your W is less than 2 and more than 1. So I have selected W somewhere here. This is the point 1 and this is the point 2. This is the point 3. So W is in between 1 and 2. I have selected. Then where will be your W plus 2? To decide the point precisely, I used graph sheet here. Okay, not otherwise. You can also just draw a rough sketch. So from W, I am measuring 2 units. So your W plus 2 comes here. And from W, I am measuring 2 units to the left side. Your W minus 2 comes here. So first select W in between 1 and 2. Then accordingly, you select the upper limit and lower limit. So your W minus 2. How to decide whether W minus 2 is less than 0? From this you subtract 2. W is greater than 1. Right? So W minus 2. Okay, W is less than 2. W minus 2 will be less than 0. Correct? 2 minus 2. So clearly W minus 2 will be left side. Now once if you decide this region, which is the common region for both PDFs? Okay. First PDF is from 0 to 3 and second PDF is from W minus 2 to W plus 2. Clearly this is the region. You can see which are the limits for this region? 1 to 3. So this covers the full width of your first PDF. First PDF is defined from 0 to 3. So this is from 0 to 3, not 1 to 3. 0 to 3. So write the limits for this convolved region. 0 to 3. Again, equal to sign is missing. Typing error. Equal to 0 to 3. Write the function values. Integrate. You get the constant answer. 1 by 4. Next case. If 2 is less than W less than 5. If W is in between 2 and 5. You can select anywhere. Okay, more than 2 you select. W I have selected somewhere here. You have to select W anywhere, but this position should be right side of your 2, but left side of your 5. Anywhere you can select. Okay, using proper scale, I have selected W here. Then what will be W plus 2? Select 2 units to the right side. W plus 2 comes here, and W minus 2, 2 units to the left side. It comes here. Okay, select the units properly. And how to decide whether this W minus 2 is to the right side of Y axis? Just to check here, if W is less than 5, W minus 2 will be less than 5 minus 2. That means 3. Correct? W minus 2 will be less than 3. And how to decide this? W is greater than 2. So here if you subtract 2, W minus 2 will be greater than 0. So clearly this point will be to the right side of Y axis. W minus 2 will be greater than 0. Okay. For this interval itself, you take W plus 2 and W minus 2 and decide upper and lower limits. So here, this is the common overlapped region. And which are the limits for this region? Upper limit is fixed, 3. Because beyond 3, you don't have the first PDF. Lower limit is not fixed, it is floating, W minus 2. Because your lower limit depends on your W. Here I selected W somewhere here, but you can select W anywhere in this region, 2 to 5. So you get W minus 2 to 3 limits. So apply these limits. Once if you apply the limits, you can evaluate the integral and you get this answer. Okay. And beyond 5, I have not given that explanation here. It is similar to your previous problem. Beyond 5, if your W is more than 5, what happens if your W is somewhere here? I have not given you the figure here. Just draw the figure yourself. If W is somewhere here, more than 5, then clearly your W minus 2 will be somewhere here. Clearly it will be right side of your 3, correct? Right side to your 0.3. Clearly there is no overlapped region. So there is no PDF, 0. So if your W is greater than 5, it is 0. So in some textbooks they may give you like this, only 3 definitions they will give you. FW of W is given by this. Elsewhere it is 0. Fourth definition will be given as 0 elsewhere. Elsewhere means other than these 3 intervals. So these possibilities. Either W is less than minus 2 or W is greater than 5. Next question. The random variable xi have same mean mu x equal to 4 and variance of sigma square x equal to 1.5. Okay. For W equal to summation I equal to 1 to 150 xi, determine mu w and sigma square w. Also for y equal to 1 by 150 of summation I equal to 150, 1 to 150 xi, determine mu y and sigma square y. Comment on the result. A very simple problem. What they have given? They have given that xi have the same mean. So it is iid random variable. Xi have the same mean and same variance. When all xi have the same mean, it comes under iid, independent and identically distributed random variables. Mu x is 4 for each random variable and variance is 1.5. And we are adding 150 such random variables. W is x1 plus x2 plus etc. xn, sum of n random variables where n equal to 150. So we already proved the result. For sum of n random variables, what is the mean? Mean of that sum is equal to n into mu x, and what is your n here? 150. And mu x is given 4. Substitute, you get. And variance for sum of n independent random variable is given by n into sigma square x. So it is 150 into the variance which is given here, 1.5. Answer is 225. Mu y. Now what is y here? Y is nothing but average of the sum of n random variables, correct? You add all n random variables where n is 150, divide by n. It is average. So you have to refer the rule of averages. Once again, go through the law of averages which is given in the previous video. Okay, what is the rule there? For law of averages, sum of the average, for the random variable, y as average of the sum, not sum of average, average of the sum. In that case, mu y, that means mean of that random variable is same as mean of each random variable x formula. This is given under your rule of averages. Just go through it, law of large numbers. And variance is given by variance of x divided by n. This is also proved in the previous video. Substitute, you get 0.01. So comment on this result. What is the comment you can write? Because of averaging, the mean remains same, but variance reduces, you can say. Actually, previous variance was 1.5 and it reduced it now. Only this comment you can write. Very simple question. Next one. The random variable x has a mean of 2 and variance of 0.5. The PDF of x is not specified. Okay, PDF is not specified. N equal to 120 independent occurrences of x be used in the sum W equal to summation 1 to 120 xi. Determine mean of W, mu W, and variance of W. And if y is the averaging random variable of x values, find mu y and sigma square y. So what is given for x? Mean is given, mu x is given, 2, and variance is 0.5. And just PDF is not specified, but it is not required. if you know that occurrences are independent, it is nothing but sum of n independent random variables, this one w. So n equal to 120 here, n equal to 120. So what is mean of w? N times mu sub mu x, multiply and write. And what is variance of w? N times variance of x, multiply and write the answer. Now y is given. Y is the average in random variable of x, correct? So add all x values, 120 x values, divide by 120. It gives you average in random variable of x. For average in random variable y, what is mu y? What is mu y? It is same as mu x, that is the rule 2, and sigma square y is nothing but sigma square x divided by n. Divide by n and check it. 0.5 by 120, you get the answer 0.004167. Next question. The random variable z is uniformly distributed between 0 and 1. The random variable y is obtained from z as follows. Y is given by 3.5 times z plus 5.25. 100 independent realizations of y are averaged. So average of y for 100 independent realizations is given as v. Estimate the probability p of v less than or equal to 7.1. If 1000 independent calculations of v are performed, approximately how many of these calculated values of v would be less than 77.1? Okay, a very good question. This is from your model question paper. Start from the given first sentence. Random variable z is uniformly distributed between 0 and 1. Okay, so what is the mean of uniform distribution? You should remember here. Mean is not given. You should remember. What is mean of the uniform distribution? If your interval is A to B, topic of first module, it is A plus B divided by 2. So mean of this will be 0 plus 1 divided by 2, that means 1 by 2. And what is the variance of uniform distribution in the interval AB? It is B minus A whole square by 12, formula. Remember the formula. So 1 minus 0 whole square by 12, which becomes 1 by 12. Okay. So I have given you the mean of Z and variance of Z here using that formula. Recall the formula, A plus B by 2, and here B minus A whole square by 12. Y is given. In the question, Y is given as 3.5z plus 5.25. For this y, what is mu y? By the linearity property of your expectation, mu y is nothing but 3.5 into mu z plus 5.25 is written as it is. Okay, which is equal to 7. Substitute 3.5 into your mu z is 1 by 2 plus 5.25. Calculate it. Substitute and calculate. You get 7. Sigma square y. Sigma square y is 3.5 whole square into sigma square z. Remember, if your y is in the form ax plus b, you studied, then variance of y is a square into variance of x. You studied that formula. If y is a into x plus b, then variance of y is nothing but variance of a square into variance of x. Okay, same formula is used here. Here this should be suffix y, sigma square suffix y, sigma y then square. So formula 3.5 whole square into sigma square z, variance of z. Variance of z is known, calculate. You get this answer. Next, what is given? Y is the function of single random variable z now, and sum of such y's, average of values of such y's is nothing but v, another random variable. So one random variable is z, using that we obtained y. Now using y, finding the averages of y, we get v. So given that v equal to 1 by 100 into summation of 1 to 100 yi. So from the rule of averages, what is the mean of v? It is same as mean of y. And mean of y is obtained here 7. And what is variance of v? It is nothing but variance of y divided by n. Substitute. N is 100 here. Substitute. You get 0.0102. Next, as n is very large, here n is large itself, n is 100, okay? As n increases, the PDF of v follows normal distribution. This is nothing but result of central limit theorem. So from central limit theorem we know that as n becomes large, probability density function of sum of random variables, here v is nothing but sum of random variables, correct? It follows normal distribution. Even this average of sum is also equal to, when n is large, even that follows normal distribution. So using that idea, p of v less than or equal to 7.1 means we convert this to standard normal variate. We don't have the PDF of v, so you cannot directly evaluate this PDF, correct? So you change it to standard normal variable. Usually when x is given here, we write x minus mu by sigma. Same idea we use here, v minus mu v by sigma v less than or equal to, upper limit is also changed to 7.1 minus mu v by sigma v. And this notation is nothing but z, standard normal variate, or you can say normalized Gaussian variate. And mu v is known, sigma v is known from the previous slide, substitute. Okay, and sigma v is nothing but square root of this variance. Substitute, you get 0.99. Probability of z less than or equal to 0.99, less than or equal to some value. That means actually from minus infinity to till here you have to consider. You can use any procedure, minus infinity to till some value means either you can use CDF table directly. Here I used CDF table, normalized Gaussian CDF table. Or if you are using standard normal distribution table, then you need to split this as area from minus infinity to 0 and then 0 to 0.99, correct? This gives you area from minus infinity to 0.99. You can also use standard normal table, ask for appropriate table in the exam. Okay, tables will be provided to you. When you use the CDF table, you get 0.8389. Now this is for one calculation. Like this, if there are 1000 independent calculations of v, in that case number of calculated values of v less than 7.1 is equal to, this is just like for one sample and 1000 samples. So for one sample you got the answer 0.8389 multiply by number of calculations 1000. So you get 838.9, nearest integer 839. Next question. The two zero mean Gaussian random variables x and y are added, w equal to x plus y, and their variances are sigma square x equal to 3 and sigma square y equal to 7. Find the characteristic function of w. Here you need the result of characteristic function of sum of two random variables. Already we discussed it in one of the previous videos. So here I am directly starting from the characteristic function of Gaussian random variable. You should remember this formula. For Gaussian random variable, characteristic function is e raised to j omega mu x minus omega square sigma square x by 2 formula. Use this formula here. Here what is mu x? Mu x is 0. 0 mean Gaussian variable. So mu x is 0 and sigma square x is 3. Substitute. So here omega square into 3 by 2 you get. Anyway, this is 0. So you get e raised to minus 3 omega square by 2. Now characteristic function of similar Gaussian random variable y is given by e raised to minus omega square into 7 by 2, because here your variance is 7 by 2. Now multiply these two characteristic functions. I have not written the formula here. You write down the formula. Characteristic function of w, phi w of j omega, write the suffix w here. It is nothing but phi x of j omega into phi y of j omega. That is a result from the sum of independent random variables for the characteristic function. When you multiply these two, both are exponential functions. I have not written that step here. Multiply and write one more step. When you multiply, both are exponential functions, so you can add the powers. So minus 3 by 2 and minus 7 by 2, you get minus 10 by 2. And omega square is a common term. So answer is minus 5 omega square. So w is also a Gaussian random variable with variance 10 omega square by 2 with the sigma is 10. Now when you simplify you get this answer, but when you write this in terms of Gaussian random variable, it becomes 10. A very simple question. Next problem. All are similar problems. The random variable u has a mean of 0.3, variance of 1.5. Find the mean and variance of y. If y equal to 1/53, summation I equal to 1/53 ui. So sum average of sum of ui is y, and correct, average of sum of ui is nothing but y, and just sum of ui is z. So what is the mean and variance formula? For mean of u, 0.3, and variance of u is 1.5. So for this formula, this is average rule. Okay, average sum of the variables ui divided by n, that means average values. So for average, what is the mean? It is same as mu u, mean of independent variable, which is 0.3. And what is variance of y? Variance of y is sigma square u. Okay, this is a mistake. Variance of y is nothing but, directly use this formula, this is not required. Actually, this should be 1/53 into sigma square u. Okay, this formula. Actually, this should be this formula. What is your n? 53. So it is sigma square u by n, divide and calculate. You get 0.0283. So just cancel this step. Directly from Vy, you write this step. Now for z, what is the formula? Z is summation of ui. So summation of n independent variable means mean of equal to n into mean of each random variable formula. And variance is n times variance of each random variable. You have the formula, just calculate and write the answer. Again, similar problem. Random variable x is uniformly distributed between plus or minus 1. Similar problem is worked out already. Correct? So what is mu x? A plus b by 2. When interval is a and b, your mu x is a plus b by 2. Formula is 0. Answer is 0. And what is variance of your uniform variable? 1 by 3 here. B minus a whole square by 12. Here 1 minus minus 1 whole square by 12. When you simplify, you get 1 by 3. This is the formula for the interval a comma b. Okay. So y equal to average. Average of 37. Values of x, correct? So for average, what is the mean? It is nothing but mean of each random variable x, which is 0, this value. And what is variance of this? Variance of this is sigma square u by n. Substitute, you get 0.009. This is similar to previous problem actually. Only this you should remember for the uniform random variable, how to write the mean and variance. And for z, it is sum of n random variables. So what is mean? Mean is nothing but n times mu x. N is 37. Add and write the answer. And variance is n times variance of x. Get the answer. A slight different problem. The random variable x is 3 plus v. So it is a function of v. X is a function of v, correct? Linear transformation, you can say x is in the form av plus b, where v is a Gaussian random variable with the mean 0 and variance 30. 72 independent realizations of x are averaged. Okay, x is given as 3 plus v, where v is Gaussian random variable. Such x values are added and divided by 72. So average values of 72 x values are taken as another random variable y. So be careful while reading the question. There is one random variable v whose mean and variance is given. This random variable is used in random variable x, and this x is used here. So step by step you have to find. So start from the innermost random variable v. Start from v. Given that v is a Gaussian random variable with the mean equal to 0 and variance equal to 30. Sigma square v and mu v. Hence, what is your x value? 3 plus v. For this, you can find expectation. Mu x is nothing but 3 plus mu v, which is 3 again because of mu v is 0. and how to find sigma square of x. If you know the formula, if y equal to ax plus b, if y equal to ax plus b, what is variance of y? A square into variance of x, just like that. Here sigma square x is obtained by 1 square. Anyway, here that coefficient a is 1. 1 square into sigma square v. Once again, it is 30. Recall this formula. I have given you the formula here. If y equal to x plus b, then vy equal to a square into vx. Now, what is given? Now, this x is used in y here. Y is 1 by 72, summation I equal to 1 to 72 xi. Average. For the average, what is the mean? It is mean of each single random variable. So mu y is same as mu x, not mu v. Mu y is same as mu x, correct? Y is in terms of x. It's a mistake again here. Here mu x. Anyway, here mu x and mu v are same. You get 3. And sigma square y is equal to sigma square x by n. So divide and calculate. So actually very simple problem. Only they have given v first, then x, then y. One after the other, you have to find. So, I am just giving you some practice problems. I think you understood all the problems which are discussed here. If you have not understood, once again go through each slide. Try to understand. Okay, otherwise, anyway, you can ask your doubts. Okay, you can send me your doubts. Here, fx of x is uniformly distributed between minus 3 and 3. And fy of y is 7 into e to the power minus 7y uy. Which type of distribution is this? This is nothing but exponential distribution. Lambda into e to the power minus lambda. Correct? Lambda into e to the power minus lambda x or lambda y. So it is exponential distribution. And fx is uniform distribution. Now, w is x plus y, where x and y are independent. Find the PDF for w. Okay. It is similar to your worked out problem, but one difference is here. One random variable is uniform and another random variable is exponential. You need some rough figures. Otherwise, you cannot decide the region properly. Draw the figures for exponential and uniform. Remember, and while reversing or finding the reflection of a PDF, any PDF can be taken. It need not be y or x. You can interchange. Okay, you have two forms of convolution integral, correct? One is integration from minus infinity to infinity, fx of x into fy of w minus x. And another formula is fy of x into fx of w minus x. Okay, both are equivalent formulae. You can use any formula. Either you can flip uniform PDF or you can flip exponential PDF. And exponential PDF is a decreasing curve. This is a decreasing curve starting from 7, I think, when y equal to 0, correct? Check this. When y is 0, what you get? 7. And here uniform distribution is having the width 6, minus 3 to 3, 6. So just find out. One answer is given here. Just check whether it is correct in this interval. And once again, random variable uniformly distributed from minus and plus or minus 0.5. And this is the exponential PDF, e to the power minus z, u of z, or exp of minus z, u of z. And both are independent, find the sum. For your convenience, if you are comfortable with only x and y, you change this to y and this to w, but mention it in the beginning. And in the final answer, again, you can replace it. You can replace w by y in the final answer. If you are changing the notation in between, in the final answer, replace it. Okay, here anyway, w is given directly. But here, y is given as x and z in terms of x plus z. Once again, random variable x has the PDF c into 7 minus x for x between 0 and 7 and 0 otherwise. So first, only for the single random variable x, this is the PDF given in the interval 0 and 7. So c value is not given. So first you have to find the value of c, find the necessary value of c. To get this as the PDF, what is the condition for PDF? Remember both conditions. First condition, your fx of x should be greater than or equal to 0, and second condition, minus infinity to infinity fx of x dx will be 1. Anyway, here interval is 0 to 7, not minus infinity to infinity. So integrate and equate it to 1, then get the value of c. And after finding that value of c, draw that figure. Okay, I think when you have a constant c here, it is in the form m into x minus a or m into a minus x. Anyway, it is a straight line. When you have only linear terms here, y equal to mx plus in that form, it is a straight line. But draw the straight line. Just select two points on the straight line. You can draw the straight line. Okay. And second curve is y is independent of x, uniformly distributed from 0 to 7. Once again, this is uniform distributed. And what is the width of this curve? 7 minus 0, 7. So this curve exists only to the positive side of y-axis, 0 to 7. Okay, you can flip any one curve, then find the common region, try to write the limits and evaluate. Okay, I have given you the answers here. This is also similar to this. Try yourself. Unless you try some similar problems, you won't get the idea. This is similar to your sum of independent random variables using the sum of n independent random variables using that law of large numbers. Okay, average. This is average. Similar problems are worked out, so I am not explaining much. Even this is sum of y values, correct? Sum of y values, but y is in terms of x, and for x mean is given, variance is given. So start from x first, then write using x find the mean of y, and then using mean of y find the mean of z, one after the other. Very simple question. Two more problems just for your practice. Okay, this similar problem is worked out. Just take a screenshot of this and try these questions yourself. So I will stop here today. In the next session, we shall discuss about conditioned random variables. Okay, and also some problems are remaining using unit delta function that I will explain you in a separate video. Okay, thank you.